Welcome back. So often athletes, especially female athletes, will show up complaining of performance metrics decreasing, sleep just not being as refreshing as it used to be, feeling like they're just kind of getting rattled more easily in competition, even feeling like they've kind of lost that confidence or their ability to do what they used to be able to do. When previously, they had no issues whatsoever. They were just like, man, I can do this. I can do this. Even if I probably can't do this, I still feel like I can do this. And what happens? They get put on, especially the ladies, put on birth control because they have anxiety, depression. It's got to be related to their hormones. There's too much hormone change happening here. And let's just turn off their ovaries. Let's use some synthetic hormones. Let's turn off the ovaries, and that should do the trick. Of course, this doesn't help. And maybe it helps marginally in some cases, but or maybe it makes matters worse in other cases. And if it doesn't, then what happens? They get sent on, let's give them on antidepressants or anti-anxiety medications because they're just not handling stress well. It's just too stressful being, a high school athlete, a college athlete. Let's give them on a sleep aid because they're waking throughout the night and they're just not getting the opportunity to refresh their bodies and repair and rejuvenate themselves. Of course, these don't help either. And it just makes the female athlete crazy frustrated. And nobody's listening and they're not getting results. And I say female athlete, but seen plenty of male athletes in a very similar situation, similar scenario, just without the birth control part of recommendations. So as is standard protocol in our office, we get a comprehensive history, we do full-on full panel blood work, and over, we end up seeing these athletes with low ferritin levels, low iron levels, low B12 levels, low protein levels. And of course, some of these have been checked, some of these have not been checked, but these have been overlooked over and over and over again. And, been told that, yeah, your labs are normal, it's nothing in your blood kind of thing. When in reality, these people are just like nutritionally deprived. They're nutritionally deficient. And that is why their body is responding and not showing up for them anymore. So athletes recognize have greater needs than the general population because they're using more resources day in and day out than the general population. And if you're just super active, you too are using a lot more resources than the general population is using and what most lab values and reference ranges are created from. One resource in particular is iron. Iron is lost through the sweat, through urine, through skin sloughing, through the gastrointestinal tract, through menstruation in ladies. But exercising at high intensity and especially endurance sports can increase iron losses by up to 70% compared to the same person living in a sedentary lifestyle. On top of that, just the fact that your foot is continually striking the ground over and over and over again, that can lead to red blood cell destruction. I mean, it does lead to red blood cell destruction, and that can make the red blood cell lifespan significantly shorter. And that's not like a unhealthy thing, but that in itself increases iron need and it increases the need for the bone marrow to pump out more red blood cells. So as nutritional needs rise, we have to also increase nutritional inputs and make sure those are optimized and put a lot more attention to them. Because my experience is it is the rare athlete who walks in the office who's eating high quality meals consistently. Many are not getting sufficient protein. They're not getting sufficient iron from their diets, while at the same time they're eating highly processed foods, sugary drinks, and they literally are leaching resources from the body with each bite, with each sip, while at the same time going out there, and hustling and playing for hours a day, running for hours. So the push towards even vegetarianism, veganism, this also only serves to compound the unmet needs of these athletes who are pushing their bodies. And a lot of them, especially if you talk to these teenage athletes, their bodies are still growing. That it's not like they've stopped growing yet. So not only is their bodies are their bodies growing and their systems trying to repair and rejuvenate what's being broken down by the athletics, they literally are still growing in height and in stature. So if you are a menstruating female performing consistent physical activity, it is extremely important to get your iron levels, your ferritin levels, your B12 levels checked, literally as a bare minimum. And I would also look at your food routine. and make sure, am I actually fueling for optimal performance, or am I just literally grabbing what is easiest, you know, the bag of chips, the bag of cookies, the bag of crackers? Am I just going for what's easiest, hustling out the door with another bag of cereal to just put something in my body so I have a little bit of energy? That's not going to work out for the long run. And that could be greatly hindering your health progress and your performance progress. So have some meat cooked up ahead of time so you can just grab it. Maybe, you know, make fruit available all the time. Make your own protein bar. You know, get some goat whey protein and make a protein bar. Blend up some goat whey protein in a smoothie with some berries and some, you know, milk or goat milk or raw milk. You know, use a high quality greens and reds formula to support digestion and vegetable intake if you're just like, I can't make this happen. Because generally vegetables are a little more challenging a lot of times to have on the road and that kind of thing. If your iron is low, you know, look at using a high absorbing, no side effect formula. Like Blood Vitality, you may have heard of it. I've talked about it before, but this has been a complete game changer for so many athletes, so many of my female patients. You know, they were going down a road they did not want to go down, being told nothing's wrong with them. Check their iron levels, their ferritin levels, they're low. Or they've been on iron supplements and have just had a disastrous relationship with iron supplements. We get them on Blood Vitality, you know, all of a sudden they start blossoming. When symptoms and signs of poor performance are present, both physically, mentally, emotionally, remember, this is not a sign of pharmaceutical deficiency. It is a sign of nutritional insufficiency or imbalance. So we fix the imbalance and literally watch your performance, your confidence, both physically and mentally, return. It's totally doable. So I'm Dr. Matt. Be sure to subscribe to this channel, DR Wholeness, if this content has been helpful to you. And share with your friends. So many people are walking around with very simple answers to their chronic issues. And so many of these videos can be helping them. So I'd love to hear your story in the comments, or you can even send us an email at info@drwholeness.com. info@drwholeness.com. I would love to hear your story. All right, talk to you guys later.